all over the world, people have been enjoying cleaner air as a result of factories being shut. COVID-19 outbreak and the resultant lockdowns enforced by nations worldwide have drastically reduced pollution. Even the ozone layer hole over the Arctic closed in March. But while all this is good news, another threat is on the rise. Over 100 countries are facing a major health crisis on an unprecedented scale. As the current coronavirus epidemic lingers, schools are shutting down, businesses are losing money, and employees are losing jobs, while residents in many countries are protecting themselves against COVID-19 by wearing surgical face masks. However, there are extra challenges that come with the crisis beyond health concerns. Masks have now become mandatory across much of the world. It is strongly recommended in hopes of stopping the spread of the coronavirus. However, its recommendations have been controversial in some areas due to low supplies. Masks have been used by aware people, but unfortunately, these new Medicare accessories have given people a new item to litter. Gloves, masks and other personal protective equipment or PPE are critical for those fighting the pandemic, but are also widely used by the public. Still, because they're not always disposed of properly, environmentalists fear negative consequences for wildlife and the fight against plastic pollution. Before moving forward, please subscribe to this channel and also press the bell icon to view these kind of interesting videos during release itself. This is a problem. First, disposed face masks are dangerous to garbage collectors. If they are not taken care of properly, used masks may be contaminated by the virus on the outside. Second, they pose a significant environmental threat as they produce huge amounts of waste. The rise of disposal masks and gloves is adding to the glut of plastic pollution, threatening the health of oceans. Marine life is already struggling against the pollution of cigarette butts, empty bottles, and discarded food wrappers. In addition to these, rubber gloves and surgical masks are now littering many city streets as well. Discarded items on the street easily get washed down drains during storms and eventually end up in the ocean or other waterways. Surgical masks and gloves are found damaging to the environment because they are often made out of fabrics and plastics. Because they are not biodegradable and come in colors, they attract marine animals. If even only 1% of the masks were disposed of incorrectly and perhaps dispersed in nature, this would result in 10 million masks per month dispersed in the environment. Considering that the weight of each mask is about 4 grams, this would lead to the dispersion of over 40,000 kilograms of plastic in nature. A dangerous scenario that must be defused as a result of irresponsible disposal, marine animals mistake face masks as food. The masks block their digestive system, eventually becoming fatal. Over time, those products break down and add to the vast collections of microplastics in our seas, air and food. And the irony is that, while we produce and discard plastic to fight one public health crisis, we may be slowly contributing to another. The risks of microplastics to human health are still being studied. One stems from the fact that microplastics passing through wastewater plants can pick up harmful bacteria, which they can carry with them. If we ingest the plastics, we may ingest the bacteria. Another is that plastics have a number of chemicals added at the manufacturing stage, and it's possible that these are released in the body. Across the globe, researchers and scientists have been working towards finding innovative solutions for proper disposal of masks and gloves, especially for places such as hospitals and police stations, where masks are being used more frequently. There is still no scientific evidence to prove that single-use plastic is better than reusable ones. With thousands of masks being discarded on the streets, this could lead to another environmental threat. The cloth type, surgical type and N95 receptor masks are the three main types of masks, which are commonly used by the people in public nowadays. The cloth mask is not ideally recommended when taking care of infected patients, as they do not provide adequate protection, but they are still better for routine use than not covering your mouth and nose. In a normal environment, a reusable mask with a single filter is equivalent to up to 20 disposable masks. But this type of masks are more environment friendly because it is reusable and biodegradable. So people in less COVID-affected zones can use this kind of eco-friendly masks. But before reusing, it should be properly washed, disinfected and dried. For surgical masks, if it's dry and the layers and shape are intact, put it in a Ziploc pouch with a desiccated gel. The gel absorbs moisture and keeps the mask dry. If the surgical mask is intact and not torn, it can be reused for 3 days. If it's worn by an infected person, it should never be reused or shared. The N95 respirator is not for routine use for the general public. In some people, it can cause respiratory problems due to low airflow. It's made of polypropylene material. These respirators filter out at least 95% of very small, 0.3 microns, particles. When you are not using it, you can store it in a closed plastic container and dispose of and regularly clean the storage containers. When reusing the N95 respirator, leave a used mask in the dry atmosphere for 3 to 4 days to dry it out. Another method is to sterilize the N95 mask by hanging it in the oven without contacting metal at 70 degrees centigrade for 30 minutes. Or use a wooden clip to hang the respirator in the kitchen oven. N95 masks are degraded by UV light, so keep them away from UV light or sunlight. Polypropylene in N95 is hydrophobic and contains zero moisture. COVID-19 needs a host to survive. Thus, we can reuse these masks and can decrease the environment impact produced by them.